Yeah, let me tell you a story. Judge Carter, it was a matter of confederation. He was a man of nation. He was friends with Jimmy Donald. He was a patriot and lawyer of the nation. He studied up to
college.
A country you learned.
Oh,
Pendis officer. 1835. A leader of the blue
party.
Good puppy was from Lower Canada
and afraid of assimilation.
He contributed so much that he introduced Confederation. He brought together the smallest of nations, really from militia.
And defense first minister.
What is there to know about him? These are the next few things we'll talk about in a few minutes.
Oft in the stilly night, ere slumber's chain has bound me, fond memory brings the light of other days around.
Want to know something about George Cartier? Let me tell you a little something about him. One of the most popular and influential politicians in his generation was George Etienne Cartier, along with the co-premier of the province of Canada, John Macdonald. You know about him. He was among one of the most enthusiastic supporters of Confederation, and he participated in 3 conferences, Charlottetown, Quebec, and London. Being one of the most primary architects of the Canadian Confederation, he was really worthy to be called the father of Confederation.
It's me again, let's continue. In 1835, the Bar of Lower Canada was conceded. George Etienne Cartier's first part of his public life connected to the cause of the Patriots. He labored to choose Louis-Joseph Papineau and Robert Nelson. He was part of the Sons of Liberty, and during the 1837 rebellion, he fought in the Battle of St. Denis. He returned to Lower Canada after an expulsion in the United States, where he practiced law from 1839 to 1848. His 2 clients were the Sulpicians, they were Catholics, as well as the Grand Trunk Railway. As a matter of fact, it was George Etienne Cartier who presented a bill to the Union Parliament to make the Grand Trunk Railway Company of Canada.
It's me again. Let's continue. When he was appointed to the Legislative Assembly of the Union of Canada as a representative for the riding of Verchères, he entered politics in 1848. He also joined the cabinet as a representative of Canada East in 1854. Etienne Pascal Taché left his political life, and George Etienne Cartier took over his place to construct a government with Sir John A. Macdonald. George Etienne Cartier eventually became the most influential politician in Canada when Sir Louis Lafontaine and Etienne Pascal Taché left.
Back at it again. George Etienne Cartier was in reconciliation with the Act of Union began in 1858 following the intellectual pace of Sir Louis Lafontaine to endorse a federation of the provinces in North America. He then went to London with Alexander Tillich-Galt and John Ross to try to persuade the Queen of the merits of British North America Union. By that time, political fluctuation in the province of Canada reached a pinnacle with less than 6 governments in 6 years. To alleviate the situation and to set act a process leading to Confederation, George Cartier participated in the Great Coalition of 1864. George Etienne Cartier was able to enter John A. Macdonald's first government, a minister of militia and defense of July 1, 1867. He even ran in the provincial election and was appointed in government Pierre-Joseph Olivier Chabot. He lost in the 1872 federal elections in Montreal East. He was also dropped into the provincial constituency in Manitoba and never witnessed in the riding.
Let's go. George Cartier supervised the settlement between the Canadian and British governments.
government and the Hudson's Bay Company in the purchase of our Western territory and Rupert's land. He also negotiated with Bishop Taché in the creation of Manitoba. He also had an active role in the Also him in 1872 who introduced the bill to the House of Commons of the Canadian Pacific Railway's construction. After George Cartier's defeat in Montreal East in 1872, he traveled to London and finding a chronic disease. Fortunately, at the age of 58, he's dead. When his political ally for 20 years, John A. MacDonald, announced his death in the House of Commons, he was reduced to tears. And that is the end of George Cartier. Thanks, everyone.
Top 10 facts. 1. 2.
Stop touching my belly.
That's your tail.
Okay, I think it's normal now.
It's
just recording.